The first time that I ever saw you smile, I want that feeling again. Let's be the way we were when we first began.
The only Bible that some people will ever read is your life. There's a lot of folk in church who are not lovable because they don't have enough Jesus in them.
Dr. T. Dubbert and First Lady Jasmine Robinson, overseers Bishop Paul S. and Dr. Deborah B. Morton from Changing Generation, invites you to worship with us in person in the sanctuary or join us virtual at our new Decatur location, 4185 Snapfinger Woods Drive, Sundays at 11 a.m. and Tuesdays at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time. Or worship with us in person in the sanctuary or join us virtual from Greater St. Stephen, Sundays at 10:30 a.m. and Wednesdays at 7 p.m. Central Time. One church in two states, Atlanta, cagnow.org, and New Orleans, houseofgreater.org.
Join us virtually as we ring in another year of God's greater glory. Greater Change New Year's Eve Watch Night Virtual Experience, Saturday, December 31st, from Decatur, Georgia, Kagman.org, and New Orleans, Louisiana, houseofgreater.org.
Coming up on Greater Change Ministry.
But hear me good, God very clearly spoke to me and said, the good wine is yours for the taking. People of God, the new wine is in position to replace what you've got. Jesus is ready to reveal his glory in your life, but you've got to do your part to be ready when Jesus comes.
Be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. From Changing a Generation Full Gospel Baptist Church in Decatur, Georgia, and Greater St. Stephen Full Gospel Baptist Church in New Orleans, Louisiana. One church in two states. Pastored by Dr. T. Delbert Robinson, along with Elder Jasmine M. Robinson, and overseers Bishop Paul S. Morton and Dr. Deborah B. Morton, welcomes you to the Greater Change Outreach Ministry. Now, prepare for a life-changing experience.
Well, God bless you, my brothers and sisters, and welcome to the Greater Change telecast. I am your host, Dr. T. Delbert Robinson.
And I am Elder Jasmine Morton Robinson.
Listen, I know preaching well enough to know that every now and then, a message from God will become a moment with God. And the word of the Lord that has come to you in this season, I believe it's for this season. It is for this nation. That's why I think God is taking you all over the place to preach this, because it's a moment with God personified. Why don't you tell them all about it, honey?
Listen, God just gave me a word that his glory has to be, will be, shall be revealed in your life. You've just got to accept it. You've got to agree, and then the abundance will take over.
Woo, my God, I want you to receive this moment in God. Let's go in to the Changing Church of Decatur, Georgia. Changing a Generation with Elder Jasmine Morton Robinson. The show must go on. Call somebody, text them, tweet them, do something, because they got to see the show must go on. We'll be back right after this.
Turn with me to the book of John, chapter 2, verses 1 through 10 in the New Living Translation. If you dare, say, I am there. Hallelujah. It says, the next day there was a wedding celebration in the village of Cana in Galilee. Jesus' mother was there, And Jesus and his disciples were also invited to the celebration. The wine supply ran out during the festivities, so Jesus' mother told him they have no more wine. She says, "Dear woman, that's not our problem. My time has not yet come." Flippant, like Pastor Rob said. But his mother told the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." I know what he said, but do whatever he tells you. I know what I told you. Standing nearby were six stone water jars used for Jewish ceremonial washing. Each could hold 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus told the servants, "Fill the jars with water." When the jars had been filled, he said, "Now dip some out and take it to the master of ceremonies." So the servants, hearing good, followed his instructions. When the master of ceremonies tasted the water that was now wine, not knowing where it had come from, though of course the servants knew, he called the bridegroom over. "A host always serves the best wine first," he said. "Then when everyone has had a lot to drink, he brings out the less expensive wine. But you have kept the best until now." Verse 11 says, the miraculous sign at Cana in Galilee was the first time Jesus revealed, somebody shout out, his glory. And his disciples believed in him. Really quickly, I want to go to verse 11 in the Amplified Version. If they have it, it says, "This, the first of his signs, miracles, wonder works, Jesus performed in Cana of Galilee and manifested his glory. By it, he displayed his greatness and his power openly. And his disciples believed in him, adhered to, trusted him, and relied on him." Somebody shout out amen for the word. Thank you, ushers. You may be seated. The word of the Lord this morning is, the show must go on. Will you look at a neighbor and tell them, the show must go on? By show, I mean the display of God's power, his goodness, his greatness, and his unspoken manifestation. All of that must continue for you and for me. Most of us have heard the phrase, the show must go on, before, but I did a little more discovery on how this phrase came about. It's what I like to do. And here's where this one came from, and I quote, it says, when a circus performer got injured performing their death-defying or otherwise demanding act, or when an animal got loose, supposedly the ringmaster and the band would keep the entertainment going so that the crowd wouldn't worry and panic. Thus, the expression, the show must go on, was born. Similar to this wedding that had run out of wine and probably would have caused a ruckus amongst the crowd had Jesus not shown up. People of God, if I take it a little further, sometimes our lives can look a little bit like an out-of-control circus. Kids acting crazy over here, finances in shambles over there, spouse tripping, health out of control, you're restless and fighting to regain your peace, you have little joy, you're overwhelmed with the cares of life, and it seems like happiness has been postponed and hasn't been rescheduled yet. But then the ultimate ringmaster, he steps in to calm us all down and remind us that I'll keep you in perfect peace if you keep your mind stayed on me. Yeah. Right in the midst of our worry, our panic, our shame, our embarrassment, he shows up as the master, comforting us and reminding us to be anxious for nothing, but to look to him for everything, because not only can he handle it, but the Bible says, he which hath begun a good work in you, he's going to perform it. Yes, he will, until the day of Jesus Christ. Tell your neighbor, he's got more work to do in me. And if anybody knows, he knows that the show must go on. The phrase, the show must go on, was later adapted in show business to mean that regardless of what happens, whatever show has been planned still has to be staged for the waiting patrons. Yeah. And I just believe that there's some waiting patrons listening to me today. You may be in a season of challenge, or you're in a season of no or not yet, and you're waiting on a miracle. You're waiting on your customized water to wine experience. So allow me to encourage you and remind you to keep living by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God, and keep believing that what the Lord promised shall come to pass. Why? Because whatever show has been planned still has to be staged for you, the waiting patrons. Tell your neighbor the show must go on. Jesus was an invited guest at the wedding. But as Pastor Rob emphasized a few weeks ago, his attendance wasn't predicated on him performing a miracle. In fact, there was nowhere on his agenda. Truthfully, in this day and time, the whole town was invited to these wedding celebrations, and it was insulting to decline an invite and not show up. So Jesus came to celebrate with the other guest as an invited guest. Nothing more, nothing less. But don't get it twisted. It's always a good thing when Jesus is on the guest list. It's a real good thing when he's invited into our situations. And I just believe that his purpose for being there shifted because of the need at that wedding. Well, what are you saying, First Lady? The wedding party had run out of wine, and they thought all they needed was more wine to continue the celebration, not knowing that the wine was just the conduit for his glory. I believe the need was magnified for him to be glorified. See, the loose animals and the injured participants in a circus, they caused the ringmaster to have to show up and show out. And I'm here to let you know the show had to go on at the wedding for his glory to go on. Can I insert a yellow light right here? We don't have to stop. Just slow down just a little bit. Try looking at the why you may be going through as an opportunity for Jesus to bring you through and get all the glory from your story. Anybody been there before? Didn't come to hurt anyone's feelings this morning, nor did I come to insult your intelligence. But at the end of the day, it's not about you. It's about his glory being revealed and you reaping the benefits from it. Somebody shout out, it's for your glory, Lord. Hallelujah. Hear me good. And in my observation of the servants who were simply the vessels, I took away some positions, some postures that we should have for his glory to be revealed in our lives. The first position is acceptance. Jesus' mother had prepped the servants to listen to her son, but I believe Jesus presented himself in a way that said, you're going to want to listen to what I'm about to tell you, because what I'm about to tell you is going to help you. I got the goods to save this party. And the servants accepted that Jesus was the authority in this moment, that this was the beginning of the preparation for the operation. That there appeared to be mutual acceptance amongst the hired staff that he could resolve the situation. For whatever reason, they trusted the mother's order to listen to him, and they trusted Jesus to give the order. Hear me good, beloved. When you give Jesus complete authority and you accept that he is Lord of your life, Lord of your finances, Lord over your body, Lord over your family, Lord over your mind, Lord over your rest, Lord over your peace, Lord of all, he will operate in that authority in your life. When you trust that he is, he will be. When you trust that he is the great I am, you will experience the I am-ness of God. And hear me, God, he doesn't need our trust to operate in his authority, but he delights in it. Yeah, I said he delights in it. Psalm 147, verses 10 through 11, it says, he takes no pleasure in the strength of a horse or in human might. No, the Lord's delight is in those who fear him, those who put their hope in his unfailing love. So when you accept his authority, you're pleasing to the master. When you submit to his rule and his reign, the kingdom hookups are endless. You think your concert hookups, your VIP interest hookups, your clothes, your shoes and purse hookups, and your free cable hookups are something. But baby, when God starts hooking you up with an endless peace that surpasses your understanding, healing for your body, your mind, and your soul, long life, a God-ordained partner, and unexpected increase. Oh, that's a whole nother level of hookups. Somebody ought ups. Not yet, not yet. They started my time and my introductions. Hallelujah. He's your source. Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's your way up, your way out, your way through, and your way to. Accept the authority of Jesus in your life, and he'll delight in being the authority of your life. Gotta move on. The second position you have to maintain is agreement. Once the servants accepted the authority of Jesus, they still had to agree to what he asked him to do, not knowing what the outcome would be. They submitted to the authority of Jesus by following his instructions to fill up the water jars, not even knowing who he was. See, the manifestation of God's glory at the wedding required their agreement with his spoken word. And believers, I'm here to tell you today, you've got to agree with his written word. Agree with what God tells you to do through his word, even when you don't know what he's gonna do, because it's his word, and God's word won't return to him void. It will accomplish what he desires. Obey him blindly. Trust his way, even when you can't see your own way. Be willing to obey him when it looks a little sketchy. Obey him when the facts don't line up. The supernatural facts will. Trust him even if you tried it before and it didn't work. Do it even when it doesn't make sense, because the Lord's glory must be revealed. He may not come when you want him to, but you better know that his timeline is going to work in your favor. We declared last week that it's going to work. Who knew that filling water jars with water would lead to an abundance of the best wine? We don't know how Jesus will show up in our situation, but I can assure you that he has zero performance anxiety. Yeah, yeah, yeah. When he's invited to the party, he's going to turn out the party. So be intentional about welcoming him in all that you do. Accept him and agree with his word. Because what I discovered in this text and what I've experienced in my own life is that acceptance of him plus agreement with him leads to the abundant from him. Do I have a living witness? See, if you keep your ringmaster, Jesus, at the forefront, Holy Spirit will work behind the scenes to tame the loose animals in your life. All the while, he's preparing the best version of you, just like he did with the wine. You look up and you'll be the testimony. Jesus accepted and agreed to his Father's command to die on the cross for us. Even though it didn't feel good, didn't make sense to him, he said, not my will, but thine be done. And we were all saved because he did. I need you to take this triple A equation and live by it. Acceptance, come on, say acceptance plus agreement equals abundance. Acceptance plus agreement means abundance. The Greek word for abundance is perisiwu. Perisiwo. It means to exceed the ordinary or the necessary. How many of you are grateful for a Savior that exceeds the ordinary? Because I don't want to live no regular life. I don't want no regular experiences. I'm not trying to be regular. I'm trying to be extraordinary. The servants, they accepted his authority. They agreed to his command. And the next thing they know, they were holding a miracle in their hand. Yeah, there was abundance of wine in their hand. Nothing but water at the agreement, but an abundance of wine when they went to deliver it. And not only was it more than they had, but it was better than what they had. Pastor Rob said the quality and the quantity changed. Hear me good, the glory that Jesus initially said couldn't be revealed because it wasn't time. In fact, was revealed when the servants agreed to fill up their water jars. That's what I want to get to you today. Their obedience prompted a move of God. Their obedience led to the overflow. How many of you are expecting the overflow in your life? Look at the power of a move of God in your life when you obey him. It says the disciples believe. Your friends, your family, all your mom and them, they'll believe in even more when you accept and agree with him. And my assignment today was to push you towards proper positioning so the show can go on in your life. The manifestation of God's glory in the earth will happen regardless. I want you to know that. His glory will be revealed. But your acceptance and your agreement will cause his glory to be fully experienced in your life. So the question is, do you want God? Do you want the show to just go on? Or do you want the show to go on without you? I believe you can help me out here that the next showing is linked to your yes, Lord. I've shown you today that there's a method to the miracle. You can drink the new wine when you're properly aligned. Some of you have been running away from what God's word has instructed you to do, but he's given you another chance to say, yes, Lord, I'll do it. You're tired of the failed relationships, but you're gonna say, yes, Lord, I'll do it. He says, get in position to fill up your water jars. You're sick of the tormenting and the sleep. I need a little more. The sleepless nights. He says, accept me as Lord of your life. Come into agreement with your word and prepare to fill up your jars. You're tired of being someone else's choice. Get in position and fill up your jars. You say, I'm tired of not having enough. He says, get ready for the exceeding abundantly above all you can ask or think. Get ready to fill them up because your story is being rewritten and the glory must go on. If Pastor Rob had the mic, he would say it's revival time. If Bishop Morton had the mic, he would say all those things happen so that. If Pastor D had the mic, she would say lights, camera, action. Jasmine had the mic, your first lady has the mic. And I'm here to tell you, the show must go on. I said the show must go on. He's ready to reveal his glory. Time out for silliness. Time out for playing. He says, come into agreement with me. Accept that I am Lord of Lords. And I will show up with my glory. Any believers in the room, say, yes, Lord, I'm ready. I'm ready to agree with your word. I'm ready to trust your plan. Agree that your glory must be revealed. Your glory must be revealed. Satan can't have it. Satan can't have it. Your glory must be revealed. Will you lift your hand? Think about what he's brought you. Think about how he worked you over. And say your glory got to be.
I told you. A message from God became a moment with God. You preached. You blessed us tremendously. I thank God for your life. I thank God for your ministry. And I just want to say to somebody, for you, the show must go on. I know it's been hard. We're coming out of the pandemic, but the key is we're coming out.
Yes.
God is moving us forward, and there's a glory that shall be revealed. Tell them that equation one more time.
Yes, so it's acceptance. Yeah. Write it down. Do what you need to do. Put it in your phone. Acceptance plus agreement equals abundance.
And I want you to operate in the abundance of God. Can I pray with you? Can we pray with you?
Yes, them? Yes.
We want to pray with you and pray for you because the show has to go on. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you right now. We give you all of the glory. We magnify your name above every circumstance. And we decree and declare over my sister and my brother that nothing will stop them in this season. Father, we come into acceptance. We come into agreement, and now we receive your maximum abundance.
Yes,
it's by the strong name of Jesus we pray. Amen,
amen,
and thank God.
Amen.
Listen, there's a number right there on the screen. We are on standby because we want to pray with you, pray for you, partner with you. Hey, send us a note and let us know how you enjoyed The Show Must Go On. Well, honey, as always, we're never out of talk.
That's right.
Never out of text, but we are out of time. So until this time next week, you keep it locked right here. And in the meantime, do everything in the between time to make sure that you make it a greater change. Bye for now. Peace.
Next week on Greater Change Ministries.
Now, if you don't hear anything I said, somebody in the room needs to hear that God is so good and he's so gracious that despite what all you have done at a moment's notice, if you get your heart right, he always leaves the back door of mercy open.
Make the best of this holiday season. Spend Christmas with Paul Morton, his newly released CD featuring Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas.
Away in a manger.
Away in a manger. No crib for his bed.
Mary, did you know?
Did you know your baby boy?
Oh, holy night. Other included songs are Go Tell It on the Mountain, Sweet Little Jesus Boy, Christmas in Vain, and Why Don't You Give Love on Christmas Day?